Instant Alpha or removing background or masking text in preview, it's very easy and it's all using the same tool, which is the Instant Alpha tool. So when you open your images in preview, you have to show the markup tool when you click on that little icon in the top right corner. And then you have all these toolbars showing up. And the Instant Alpha is the second from the left. It's called Instant Alpha. And you have like this little stick with dashes all around. If you click on that, if you have an image, now you have a crosshair cursor. And if I just like start dragging on my trackpad, you will see this peachy color coming up. And this is basically showing you, if I let go of my trackpad, now I have these dashed lines. It's showing me what area will be deleted. So once this is like that, and you see these dashes kind of like moving, you can click delete, and this removes the background. Now, if you have a more complex image, let's say we have an image here, and you can see that people are touching here, and there's a variation of the clothing they're wearing. So it can become tricky when it's removing things. So for example, if I click Instant Alpha and start removing it, I'm holding the trackpad and dragging it. So the more I drag, more color and more things will be selected. However, you can see that it's covering some of the clothing. So I'm going to reduce the amount of selection. So I'm reducing the amount of selection by going back. So what you can do is select this and click delete. And then you can keep selecting, so you can take a little bit more time, but it's going to be more accurate. You have to be a bit patient and you may have to do several times, but you can have a better effect and more accurate effect. So you can do that like that. And also, if let's say I select something, I make a mistake and you let go, the way to cancel this, you just click escape. And so basically that's how to work with complex images, and you can keep going. Now, let's say if you have image such as this, you know, I can select the tree by clicking the Instant Alpha, and I can see that the dashes are moving, so I can click delete. I can also undo this and do the background, select the background, or I can also select the background and then go to edit, Invert Selection. So now it's going to delete everything but what I selected, and click delete. Now it's deleting the tree. So sometimes using the Invert Selection is a better option than if you have a lot of things going on in your image. Sometimes just a quicker way, but it doesn't work 100% always. For example, let's see if I'm going to do this, deleting the background, but let's say I want to delete the continents, inside the continents. So I'm going to select the background and go to edit, Invert Selection, and do delete. And it worked fine everywhere except this area by Africa. So sometimes, you know, it's actually better just to do it individually. So I'm going to do individual selection this way. So you can just play around and do as much as you want, and you can do several times. Sometimes it's better to just do little by little to have a more accurate selection. Once you have it, now what's really cool in preview, what you can do, especially if you have something like Canva and many times you want to remove the backgrounds or do masking, you can use this. You can just export the image to your desktop or a folder, and then opening in preview, remove the sections you want, and then I can do Command A, copy, and put it over a background to make this cool effect. And this is kind of like a image masking. Now you can also do the same thing, the masking with text. So I have a text here. I can either do letter by letter. So I'm going to try to do each letter individually. And what's really cool about this effect is because in Canva they have already letters, but just in one font, that you can use this masking effect. This way you can use any font you like, and you can remove the background. You can copy, Command A, Command C, go to a background that you like, and do Command V to paste. And look at this, it looks beautiful. And we can also do Invert Selection for text. So if I have this text, it might work if I just do quickly like this, select the background, go to edit, invert selection, and delete. However, you know, I can see that there's an issue with an A, so maybe I would have to do it individual, but for some fonts, it works fine. For others, it doesn't always work, but even like that, it looks pretty cool. If you're masking text, just be aware that if you are exporting your text from Canva with any kind of shadows or 3D effects, it's going to be hard to do the removal of background. So you want to make sure you have a normal text when you're exporting Canva. Don't create any 3D or shadow effects on your text. These are really cool things you can do very quickly in preview.